In this video, we'll be taking a look at the standard set operations and also learning a bit about Venn diagrams as a way of visualizing the way the set operations work when you're dealing with a very small number of sets. The two primary set operations are intersection and union. The intersection of two sets, A and B, the symbol for intersection is this upside down U-shaped figure. And the intersection can be described as the overlap of the two sets, that is, the set of all things which belong to A and also belong to B. So the intersection of two sets is what they have in common. To be an element of the intersection, you have to belong to both of them. The symbol for union is a right side up U-shaped symbol. The union of two sets consists of all the things that belong to either one of them. The criteria for being in the union is simply that you belong to one or you belong to the other. You might belong to both, but you don't have to belong to both. So the union of two sets is all the things that are included in at least one of the sets, perhaps both, but you're not required to belong to both. To state it verbally, an element of A intersect B belongs to both A and B, whereas an element of the union is required to belong to at least one of the sets, perhaps both, but not necessarily both. A Venn diagram, when we're talking about two sets, consists of two overlapping circles. In this case, the sets are A and B. So I have a circle labeled A. I have another circle labeled B. And those two circles are housed inside a rectangle, which represents, in some sense, a universal set. The intersection of the two sets is all things they have in common. So to visualize the intersection, we simply visualize the region which the two circles have in common, that is, the space in the picture which is inside of both circles. It's painted blue in this picture, and the blue points are the points that are inside the A circle and also inside the B circle, so we visualize that as representing the things that belong to A and to B. So the Venn diagram is simply a way of visualizing the overlap of the two sets. When we look at union, remember the criteria for union, the criteria for membership in the union, is only that you belong to at least one of the sets. So if we take everything inside the A circle and paint it blue, and if we take all the space inside the B circle and paint that blue, when we're done, everything that's inside of either circle is painted blue. And that corresponds to the union. The union includes everything in A and also everything in B, not just the overlap. So here we have a visualization of the set operation A union B. It includes all of everything that's in A, and it also includes everything that's in B. Let's consider a situation where we have a universal set U, including all the whole numbers from 1 to 9. And we have the three subsets of U described as A, B, and C here. Let's locate all this information appropriately in a Venn diagram. So we start by drawing a picture where we have a rectangle representing the universal set, and three overlapping circles representing A, B, and C. So we've drawn three overlapping circles and labeled each circle to represent one of the sets. So we'll want to locate the numbers 1, 2, 3, and 4, the elements of A, inside the A circle, the elements of B inside the B circle, the elements of C inside the C circle. But when we place all the numbers, we want to make sure that they are inside exactly the right sets and not inside of sets which they do not belong to. Starting with the number 1, we have no choice but to put it right here in the Venn diagram, because 1 belongs to A, it belongs to B, it does not belong to C. So we have to put it in the Venn diagram so that it's inside the A circle, inside the B circle, but outside the C circle, and that's exactly where we've put it. This little piece of the picture right here is the only part of the picture where we're showing things inside of A, the A circle, inside the B circle, but outside the C circle. The number 2 has to go in this region because 2 belongs to A but does not belong to B or C. So 2 has to be inside the A circle and outside the B and C circles, which means in this portion of the picture I'm pointing at. 3 belongs to A, B, and C, so it goes in the center part of the picture. And if you fill in the rest of the numbers, you should get what's shown right here. For example, the number 8 lies in this outer area because 8 does not belong to any of the sets A, B, or C, so it has to lie outside of all three circles. 5 lies in B, but it does not lie in A or C, so it goes in this portion of the picture. So go over all the numbers in the picture and make sure that you agree with where they're located. The distributive law for unions is a sometimes useful property of the set operations. If we form the union of A with the intersection of B and C, the distributive law for union says what we get is the same thing as if we union A with B, union A with C, and then form the intersection of those two pieces. Let's try to visualize the distributive law for unions in the context of a Venn diagram. Let's first look at the expression on the right side of the equation. A union B would correspond to the shaded region in the picture here. The green hash marks going in this direction have shaded everything that's in A union B. Now let's shade everything in A union C with lines going in the perpendicular direction. The lines running from upper left to lower right have been used to shade everything in A union C. The whole expression on the right is the intersection of those two parts. So if we look in the picture at the part of the picture which is shaded with lines going both directions, the overlap of A union B and A union C would be everything that's in A plus this little piece right here of B intersects C. So it's this inside the A circle plus this little piece down here. That's the portion of the picture that's shaded with lines going in both directions. So that's the visualization of the set on the right side of the equation. Now let's visualize the set on the left side. First, let's visualize B intersect C. The little blue football is B intersect C, the overlap of the B and C circles. If we union that with A, then we get that football plus everything that's inside of A. So let's paint the inside of A blue. And what we have is exactly the same region, isn't it? The part that's painted blue in the left picture is the same part of the Venn diagram as the part that's shaded with the lines going both directions in the picture on the right. So that illustrates that the set on the left side of the equation up here is really the same set as the set on the right side. De Morgan's law says that if you look at the complement of the union of two sets, what you have is the same thing as the intersection of the two complements. So let's visualize De Morgan's law with a Venn diagram. Let's first concentrate on the set on the left side of the equation. A union B in the Venn diagram is the region painted blue. So the complement would be everything in the universal set which is not painted blue, which would be the gray border area outside. So it's the gray area in this picture that represents the set on the left side of the equation. Now let's move over and try to visualize the set on the right side of the equation with a different Venn diagram. Let's start out by painting the set A green, so the inside of the A circle is green. Now let's come along and paint the inside of the B circle red. So everything in A was painted green, and then everything in B was painted red. So it's what's not in A and not in B, which hasn't been painted at all. That is the complement of A and the complement of B. Anything that's in the complement of A and in the complement of B has not been painted, and that's the gray area on the outside. So that represents the set on the right, and we get the same thing as what we got when we represented the set on the left. The other one of De Morgan's laws says that if you have the complement of an intersection, it's the same as the union of the two complements. See if you can work through a visualization of that. For the left side, the intersection of A and B would be the blue football-shaped region shown here. So the complement of that would be all the white area. Look at that and see if you can observe that that's the same thing as what you would get if you took the complement of A, everything outside of A, and unioned it with the complement of B, everything outside of B. The only thing that's not outside of at least one of the two sets is the blue football-shaped region. Let's use the letters M and B to represent two groups of students in a university. M being the students that are studying mathematics, and B be the students that are studying business. Write down the set that describes each of the following groups of students. First, students studying math but not studying business. Students who are studying math but not studying business would be students who belong to the set M but who do not belong to the set B. So we're talking about the intersection of M and B complement. Students who are studying both math and business would be the intersection of M and B. To belong to this set of students, you have to belong to the student studying math, and you also have to belong to the set of students studying business. The students studying either math or business would include everybody studying math. It would also include everybody studying business, so it would be the union of the two sets. To qualify to be in this group, you have to be studying at least one of the two topics, but you don't necessarily have to be studying both. Students who study neither math nor business, you could describe that in two different ways. M union B would be the people who are studying at least one of the two subjects, So the complement of that, M union B, the whole thing complemented, would be the students who aren't studying either one of those topics. Or you could also characterize that as the students who are not studying math and who are not studying business. We know that these two sets are the same because of DeMorgan's law. What about students who don't study math and who don't study business? Well, that's the same thing all over again, isn't it? It's just another way of describing the same set of students. Don't study math and don't study business. M complement, intersect, B complement. Or you could say that's who you have if you eliminate all the people who study at least one of the two subjects, that is, take the complement of the union of the two. Let's do some sketching of regions representing sets. Sketch the region corresponding to the set A union B complement, that whole thing intersected with C. How do we visualize the part of this Venn diagram that represents this set? Let's start with what's in parentheses here. A union B complement. I'm painting A blue. Now let's paint B complement blue. Paint everything outside the B circle blue. So we've painted A blue, we've painted B complement blue. So the union of those two is now everything that's painted blue. What do we get if we take that blue set and intersect it with C? What portion of that blue set is inside of C? It would be this part of C right here, wouldn't it? That is, we would wind up with this piece that's left. So that blue region in the Venn diagram is the region that represents the set shown above.